great.
Oh, thanks.
I feel like every time I see you, your hair is a different color.
It is. It definitely is.
How often do you change your hair color?
I've changed it actually 6 times this year.
You're kidding.
No, I'm not.
And the fact that you still have hair left is amazing.
I know. I go to an incredible salon.
There you go.
They're really good at what they do.
Very important.
I'm just happy I still have hair on my head.
Now, have you met Michael before?
No, we've never met.
And all the times you've co-hosted here,
But you do remember me from something I heard.
Yes, I do. When they told me that you were co-hosting, I said, I know him from Chunky Soup commercials with his mom. You betcha.
Chunky Soup. Well, Chunky Soup.
You love it. That is your career in a nutshell.
And I'm thinking, Chunky Soup? Yeah.
But you're not a Giants fan. You're a Cowboys fan.
I'm a Cowboys fan. I'm really sorry. Yeah. But I did do some research.
Oh, my gosh.
And I know that you won the Super Bowl.
Yes.
In 2007.
Yes.
I know my stuff. Good girl.
Now, your mom is a Dallas Cowboy cheerleader, right?
Yes. And she's actually here.
Is she here? Where is she? Can we see her? Can I tell
she's
you?
She's going to kill
me. That is the greatest job ever. It is everybody's job that they always wanted their entire life, ever since we saw the Love Boat and the Dallas Cowboys cheerleaders was on the Love Boat.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
The people not applauding are your age and don't remember that show.
No, you just had a birthday.
I do. I did. Sorry. I'm 20 now.
Oh, my gosh. Are you 20 years old?
I know. I'm getting so old.
No. Oh.
Totally kidding.
Did you do anything fun?
I did. I spent my new adult birthday at a giant trampoline warehouse.
No kidding.
Yes, that's for kids.
Right.
I've been there.
Really?
Yes.
It's in
California?
Yes, in California.
Oh, yeah.
You're kidding.
Took the kids. Loved it.
Right. He took his kids, and I went with my friends, who are definitely not kids.
Are you good at like flips and stuff like that? Or?
No, but it was still a lot of fun, and I just felt like it was like really pure, innocent fun, and it just was like so awesome to feel like you're a
great
kid
to be
again.
A kid, right?
Yeah,
yeah. When we come back, we're gonna find out why Simon Cowell calls Demi a brat. He's got some nerve. We'll be right back.
That's Demi's number one hit, Give Your Heart a Break, which you're going to perform at the VMAs tomorrow.
Yes, the pre-show. So.
Oh, my gosh. How exciting. By the way, that was auburn color hair, right? Or
yes,
brown hair.
It's that gorgeous. Was about 4 colors.
You look good with every color.
Thank you.
Do you have a favorite?
I think this is my favorite right now, just because, you know, it's the color I have. And I don't feel like changing it.
But, you know, everyone sees you now. You're on X Factor, which is a huge show.
Oh, my gosh.
And you have the number one song. But I see you have quite a few tattoos, and I know they all mean something, because you've been through quite a lot,
mm-hmm.
quite a bit. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I have, I think, like 12 tattoos now. But I have them all in, like, pretty... Not hidden places, but they're just places you wouldn't think. I have
look at that.
Rock and roll and Peace that need to get touched up, so I'm not going to show those.
Right.
Like Kiss, Cross. I have.
Are those your lips? Are those your lips on your arm?
No, they were my friend's lips, and it was just a spur of the moment stupid decision.
And do you ever think about removing any of them?
Yeah, I've thought about it before because I'm like, you know, when I get older, I don't know if I'm going to want to have rock and roll on my middle finger.
Oh, I'm telling you.
But, you know, whatever. I'm young and I can rock it now. And when I get older, I can worry about that later.
Michael had mentioned you've been through so much.
Yes.
Your parents sort of intervened on your behalf at a certain point in your life when it became
yes.
sort of unmanageable. Tell me about that.
Well, you know, I got into a situation in a different country where I actually ended up hurting one of my friends. And mm-hmm. I was just going through something that was so dark, and I was very, very mentally sick.
Mm-hmm.
So when I landed after leaving a tour, my parents were they had planned an intervention.
Mm.
And thank God I said yes, because they actually were like, we already called the police, so
right.
if you're saying no, you're kind of screwed. You're going anyways. So.
Right. Wow. But yeah. You were diagnosed with bipolar disorder.
Yeah.
And so that, I think on the one hand, it's such a hard diagnosis to hear, but I would think on the other hand, it might be a relief to have a diagnosis. Mm-hmm.
It was, because I was like, oh my gosh, that means I'm not really crazy. Like, there's a reason.
Right.
And it was just so awesome to be like, you know, to be able to pinpoint a diagnosis for the reasons why I was extremely amazingly happy and like in a euphoric state, and then like the next month I was in this deep depression and I had everything great in my life. I had nothing to complain about, but I wasn't happy.
Well, and you're doing great now, and
we're so happy you're doing well, and now you're on the X Factor, and you're judging with Britney Spears. And how is it to work with Britney, and also how is it to work with Simon?
Well, Britney's amazing, and L.A. is amazing.
She's incredible. Oh, I mean, L.A.
Oh, you didn't say anything. I asked you about Simon. You said Britney and L.A. Okay. There we go.
No, he's really fun to work with, too. We have a lot of fun together. I definitely give it back to him. I don't put up with it.
Yeah. Well, and where does that come from? Where does your bravery come from?
I'm a Southern girl who speaks her mind, and if you're gonna dish it, you might as well be able to take it.
We've got this great clip. Let's take a look right now. I guess you and Simon are dishing it to each other. Here's the X Factor.
Do you have any pets?
I have one small chihuahua.
What's his name?
What? Paul Newman.
If I had a dog, I'd call it Demi.
Oh, snap.
If I had a pig, I'd name it Simon.
Demi, we're glad you're doing great, and we will be watching X Factor. The season premiere is September 12th, 8 p.m. on Fox. Next up, Meredith Vieira.